From the Weather NorCal Command Center, this is your morning update.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Chief Meteorologist Mike Krueger. Let's get you right through Krueger's quick cast for your Tuesday, November 5th. I want to start off with a wind advisory that's been issued by the National Weather Service here for basically west of the valley in the foothills, and it does include Glen and Butte counties. Now, you'll notice that it doesn't include Corning, Red Bluff, or even the Redding area, but keep in mind, it's still going to be very windy there as well. But you can see the winds out of the north, 20 to 30 miles per hour, could see those gusts upwards of 50 miles per hour. Same story here. Corning all the way up to Redding are still going to be looking at some high fire danger. So the red flag warning, really for all intents and purposes, should include even up to the north. And I'm going to show you why. Let's take a look at the winds. Yeah, okay, we can see that this afternoon that the winds will be strongest down to the south around Chico, Willows, and still over 20 miles per hour, most likely around the Redding area as well. Now, as we take you into your Wednesday, look how strong the winds are again, especially up towards Redding, Red Bluff, and Willows. East side of the valley, not as bad, but look at the foothills east of the valley. You're seeing a lot of reds in there. And look at southern Trinity County, too. Some pretty gusty winds there as well. Now, as we go into Wednesday afternoon, the winds will start to subside. They'll get even weaker by the time we get into Thursday. So Thursday is going to be looking at some weaker winds, and that should certainly help. But again, look at the humidity levels here. By noon today, we're talking into the single digits to lower teens. Now, we take you into your Wednesday, same situation, still looking at very low humidity, and that'll be the case on Thursday. But as you saw on Thursday, the winds will certainly be weaker as we go into Thursday afternoon. All right, so I just wanted to kind of give you some of that looking at the fire danger, because that's really the main headline here for today. We take you out the door this morning, mainly clear skies, and I do expect to maybe see some patchy fog for those of you along the coast. Otherwise, there will be some of that clearing. So you can see the satellite image here. This is actually the system that passed through us yesterday and did clip Northern California and give a few showers here and there, especially up to the north. But overall, we got a storm system to our west. We're basically between systems, and we've got high pressure, which is really beginning to settle in, and that's what's going to give us the dry conditions for the rest of the week. Now, looking at futurecast for today, here you can see by noon, yeah, a couple of passing high clouds out there, but nothing to be concerned about. And then we go into this afternoon and evening, and it looks like even some clearing skies out there. So here's what we have in store for us today. Temperatures basically hovering around 70, give or take, for the valley. 40s, 50s for the higher elevations, although in Trinity County and in the inland areas, mid to upper 60s, and along the coast, we're talking temperatures in the upper 50s, maybe even some low 60s in there as well. Let's take a look at that 7-day outlook for the valley. Those temperatures are going to be basically going up and down, upper 60s to low 70s here. And here's what I've done here with the 7-day outlook. Windy conditions here for the valley Tuesday, Wednesday, Wednesday down Thursday, Friday. Showers, I think best chances will be Saturday, a break on Sunday, and then maybe more showers by Monday of next week. And that's really the case for everybody. There you can see, of course, the dry conditions through Friday for the coast, inland, and for Trinity County. And taking a look at Siskiyou, Modoc, and the Eastern Mountains, dry through Friday. Snow levels, by the way, around 4,500 feet, give or take. That'll be the case both Saturday and Monday. All right, that's a look at your quick cast. Want to show you this. Look at Sue. She sent us this beautiful picture out in Cottonwood. Look at those beautiful colors that we have out there. Some of those purple in there. If you want to share your photo, you can do that just by going to the free Weather NorCal app. Scroll to the very bottom of the app and you'll see a place where you can share that photo. And it's very easy. It walks you through the process. All right, let's get you into the deeper dive forecast. It's going to be drier and warmer this week. But as I mentioned, gusty winds, elevated fire risk through at least tomorrow. Weaker winds, though, later in the week. And I do expect some showers as early as Saturday. and then coming again on Monday of next week. Real quick look at the Shoe Fire. We are seeing some better containment as of yesterday. It was 97% contained yesterday. Today it's at 98%, and we're probably going to see that improve over the next 24 hours. Once again, we take a look at that satellite image here. You can see the storm system that passed through us yesterday. That's producing rain and snow along that boundary, but doesn't look like it has a whole lot of moisture to work with. High pressure is really what's going to be settling in. You'll notice what was happening is that high pressure settles in. We've got low pressure coming down from the south. That's what's really helping to kind of drive in some of the stronger winds. So the clouds that we're seeing here is coming in that flow of that jet stream, and that jet stream is what's helping to transport those clouds in, but it's also a contributing factor to the gusty winds that we will see out there today. So again, there's that area of high pressure, low pressure to our south, to our east. There are those strong winds we got coming in from the north. As this digs to the south and this moves a little bit closer, the winds may even be stronger going into your Wednesday. Then this will all shift eastward, and that's going to allow us to warm up a little bit and the winds to die down for Thursday, Friday. Here's the approaching storm system that should most likely be here. It looks like by Saturday. There it is. Saturday, the chance for some showers will be between systems. This is what's coming in on Monday of next week, and looks like some substantial rainfall and maybe even some snow for some of those higher elevations as we go into Monday. And then Tuesday kind of lingers a little bit, as you can see here, but more unsettled weather coming in from the west. So it looks like a cooler and more unsettled pattern for next week. And in fact, the Climate Prediction Center's kind of showcasing that here with the wetter than normal conditions here in the forecast, and kind of closer and more within that cooler than normal category for most of Northern California. And you can kind of see that on the 10-day trend here. We've got temperatures kind of going up and down, upper 60s to about 70 through Saturday. But notice the dip in the temperatures. And this is something I've been kind of highlighting and talking about over the last, the last 24 hours, is that when we start to see, especially this time of the year, when we start to see kind of a nice dip in the temperatures here, that's a sign of some cooler and more unstable air that could be moving in. So that's why Monday is looking at a decent chance for some rain, and then off and on chances for rain possibly is a very good possibility going through next week. Now we take a look at the wave heights. Today there's still a bit of an issue. If you need to be on a small boat, just be aware of that, but we do expect to see improving conditions going into your Wednesday. So your marine forecast for today, north winds at 15 to 20 knots. There you can see your waves here. Now there is a small cracked advisory that won't take effect until later this afternoon. Here's your Trinity County neighborhood forecast along the Highway 299 corridor. We're talking low to mid 60s for your daytime highs, 61 for Trinity Center and Ruth, about 62 degrees. There you can see dry through Friday, showers entering the picture by Saturday. There's a look at your North Coast neighborhood forecast. Central and southern Humboldt County, we're looking at temperatures around 60 for Blue Lake, 67 in Garberville, and Shelter Cove, about 64. Up north, about 63 for Smith River, 60 degrees for Klamath, Trinidad about 60. Inland, temperatures mainly in the upper 60s for those daytime highs. Let's take you to Siskiyou County, and again, you'll notice the main story as far as rain is concerned, it's Saturday and then again Monday for everyone. Snow levels on average in the mountains will be about 4,500 feet. But for today, it's dry, 47 degrees for Tule Lake, 46 for Canby and California Pines, and Aden about 44. Your Eastern Mountains neighborhood forecast, I don't think I can stay in here because that's going to be talking about Paradise here in a second here. Paradise about 65, 62 degrees for Quincy, and there you can see Mineral about 54 degrees. And again, that chance for those showers coming in by Saturday. Here's your Valley neighborhood forecast. Cast brought to you by Walgamuth Painting. Your temperatures right around 70, give or take. Windy conditions today and tomorrow. Winds die down by the end of the week. There's that chance for showers by the weekend. 68 degrees for a high today in the city of Shasta Lake. 69 for Redding, all the way down to Red Bluff. And we take a look at that 7-day outlook for Redding. Again, windy conditions, upper 60s for your Tuesday, Wednesday. The winds die down, that is, for Thursday, Friday around 70. There's the chance for showers by Saturday. Probably a break on Sunday, and then Monday, a chance for more showers. That's your morning update. I'll be back again this afternoon for your latest forecast. Until then, have a great morning.
Wiggly mouth.
Woggy mouth.
No.
Painting.
Wiggy mouth.
It's Woogie Mouth Painting.
It's Walgamuth Painting. And yes, we'll paint anything.